Welcome back. We will have a discussion about analgesic in this video. In our previous videos about the medicinal chemistry, that is, this is the second video in the case of our medicinal chemistry. In the previous video, the general introduction about the medicinal chemistry, how the medical research is taking place, put forward to human beings for making a large number of medicines, and the classifications of the medicines, and initially about the general classifications like our antipyretic, analgesics, and structural based classifications, action, mode of action, like that. In the previous video discussed about the antipyretic drugs, the examples given in the case of our antipyretic drugs, how the antipyretic medicines are working on, an example for the antipyretic drugs. In this case, analgesics. So analgesics are the medicines that used to relieve the pain, so which are simply known as painkillers or pain relievers. So the definition says that analgesics refers to the medications that provides relief from pain without inducing the sleep or loss of consciousness. Again, the definitions, some more definitions are given here. The term analgesics encompasses here class of drugs that are designed to relieve pain without causing the loss of consciousness, and the drug which relieve the pain by acting on central nervous system and reduce without loss of consciousness. So here, based on the definitions, simply point out that analgesics are the chemical compounds or drugs, so which is may be administered to relieve the pain in such a way that the person is having full consciousness. That means without loss of their consciousness, they can go for the regular work. And if they have any pain, they are consulting the doctor, doctor prescribing some medicines. Once they are consuming the medicine, they are free from the pain, but they have conscious and their routine work are going on, so that those things are called analgesics. So there is a classification in the case of analgesic. Analgesics are classified in two category, is a narcotic analgesic and non-narcotic analgesics. So narcotic analgesics means which produce depression on central nervous system. So already we in the definitions already we pointed out that analgesics is acting on central nervous system, CNS, central nervous system. So if the narcotic drugs means which produce a depression on central nervous system, whereas non-narcotic drugs which do not produce any significant depression of the central nervous system. Examples are the salicylates and related compounds are the class of examples in the case of the analgesics. So other classification in the case of our analgesics, natural analgesics and synthetic analgesics. So natural analgesics are morphines and codeine, and synthetic analgesics are pethidine and methadone. And how they are acts of working is taking place. Peripherally acting agents, salicylates, aspirins are the example in the case of our peripherally acting agent. So other non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, examples that brufen, naproxen, acetaminophen are the class of analgesics in the case of our peripherally acting agents. Whereas in the case of the centrally acting agent, the categories are weakly narcotic and strongly narcotic. So those things are having some depression in the CNS. So that the weakly narcotics are codeines and oxycodone and tramadol. Strong narcotics are morphines and meprinine is the example in the case of our analgesics. So these are the general characteristic features of the analgesic. If there is an analgesic, any medicines may be analgesic, mean that must be good analgesic, should not be toxic, and which should not cause any gastrointestinal complications. It should not create any cardiovascular depressions. Some example here, aspirin. Aspirin is, we know that it is an 2-acetoxybenzoic acid or acetyl salicylic acid. It is a good analgesic, but it is a toxic to the liver. Sometimes it causes the bleeding from stomach wall and gastric irritants. So that these aspirins, or even though it is a very good analgesic and it is a blood diluent, so the restricted amount of aspirin is being given because it is having a dangerous side effects, like making a liver damage. So these are some of the examples in the case of our analgesics. Naproxen, the structures of the different compounds that it has been given here: naproxen, ibuprofen, and diclofenac sodium, and novalgine in betazolinone, and phenyl betazone or tramadol. So these are the various class of analgesics which has been given here in the case of our, some examples is given in the case of analgesics. Thanks for watching this video. Like it, subscribe it, and share it for more number of videos. Thank you.